Here's something we didn't see as we watched Senator Chuck Schumer threaten Supreme Court Justices Kavanaugh and Gorsuch over the Louisiana abortion law, or as we saw Hollywood actress Busy Phillips brag that she wouldn't be successful today if she hadn't had an abortion at age 15 because she traded her human baby for an electric car. What we didn't see was the truth about abortion regret. Amber Pike, the star of a new Netflix reality show called Love is Blind, says her ex-boyfriend pressured her to have an abortion, and she says she regrets it. This is absolutely heartbreaking. Take a look.
Hold him. I think I might be pregnant. And immediately, he's in problem-solving mode.
Well, how are we going to fix this? Like, it wasn't... Oh, God.
No, I got you. I know where you're at. I know what's going on.
I don't have kids right now, so obviously I didn't follow through with the pregnancy, and it was the.
Hey, you're okay.
It's really the hardest thing I've ever gone through in my life. I had an abortion. It's not exactly something that's like. I'm proud of. After the fact, we're just talking, and like I'm trying to explain what I'm going through. Like, I'm having a really hard time getting out of bed in the morning. I don't eat. I'm not really sleeping. This was supposed to be my other half. And his reaction, he goes, "Why don't you just get over it? You just need to get over it already. Like, move on. That is the last thing in the world you want to hear. Like, I need to know if a situation like that comes up and an unexpected pregnancy happens, I'm not gonna be, I won't be forced to choose. I can't survive that again. Like it would destroy me."
Abortion clinics dismiss this regret, but Amber's story is far from unique, and the data proves it. One study shows that 64% of women who've had abortions felt coerced or pressured into obtaining that abortion. 65% of these women suffered symptoms of trauma following their abortion. According to a study from Finland, the suicide rate for women skyrocketed in the year following an abortion to 7 times the suicide rate of women who continued their pregnancies and gave birth. According to the Washington Examiner, women are 34% more likely to develop an anxiety disorder and 37% more likely to experience depression after an abortion. So why don't abortion clinics warn women? Why don't pro-abortion activists report how many women suffer mental health issues after abortion? Why don't we let women talk about this? Why does the abortion lobby deny that women are suffering? Why do they parade Hollywood actresses like Busy Phillips who pretend abortion made everything okay, when everybody can see how deeply damaged she is? Why don't we ask the question, how many women suffer regret after their abortion? If we care about women, we should relentlessly inform women that the consequence of abortion isn't just death for the baby, but for the mother, it's increased risk of serious mental health issues, suicide, infertility, trauma, and regret. That's the truth about abortion regret. Thank you to Amber Pike for the courage to tell the truth.